We've done a couple examples now of how a lessor would account for a finance lease under IFRS 16. So let's look at an example for an operating lease. But first, remember that the difference between an operating lease and a finance lease is that with an operating lease, the lessor is not transferring substantially all the risks and rewards of ownership to the lessee. Okay, so they are going to retain the asset on their statement of financial position, and they're going to record depreciation for it over its economic life, not just the lease term, but its entire economic life. Okay, so that's one difference when we have an operating lease. Another difference is the lessor is not going to recognize any kind of a sale or cost of goods sold. It doesn't matter, even if they're a manufacturer or dealer, they're not booking a sale, and they're also not going to record any lease receivable. And because they're not having a lease receivable, they're not going to recognize interest revenue for the lease. They're just going to record lease revenue every period. And I'll show you the specifics of how that will go. Let's just say that we've got a 3-year lease here, and we've got the rental payments of $100,000 a year, with the first payment made at the beginning of the year. So day one of the lease, we're going to have a $100,000 payment from the lessee to the lessor. And we have a cost basis and the asset of $250,000 to the lessor. That's important because the asset is staying on the lessor's statement of financial position, and they're going to depreciate it. So we need to know its economic life, okay, in terms of years. So 10 years. So assuming we use straight line depreciation method and we have a salvage value of zero at the end of year 10, we would have $25,000 of depreciation expense each year, okay, for the lessor. Now, let's get to it. So day one of the lease, the lessor is going to receive $100,000 cash from the lessee. So they're going to record cash that's going to increase the cash account. Now, they do not recognize lease revenue yet. Instead, they record unearned lease revenue. Okay, so they increase that by $100,000, and that is a liability on their statement of financial position. Why are they increasing unearned lease revenue instead of lease revenue? Because they are only going to recognize lease revenue at the end of the year when they say, oh, okay, now the lessee has used this thing that we rented to them, whether it be equipment or whatever. So when they receive the cash, recognize unearned lease revenue, a liability, and then at the end of the year, so December 31st, 2022, end of year one of the lease, reduce the unearned lease revenue account, reduce that liability, and increase lease revenue, because now that revenue has been earned, and so this will affect the lessor's income statement, okay? No interest revenue, none of that. We just have this lease revenue right here of $100,000, and it's going to be $100,000 each period. It's recognized on a straight line basis. Now, the depreciation expense, I said we had $250,000 cost basis in the asset, okay? That was in the given information, $250,000, and we expected at the end of its economic life, which was 10 years, the lease term was 3 years. This is a 3-year lease, but they believe that the asset would continue to have value. The economic life is 10 years, okay? So at the end of 10 years, they believe the salvage value would be zero. So $250,000 cost basis minus zero salvage value, $25,000 a year in depreciation expense. So that's what we got here, and it's recorded at the end of year one. So the lessor is going to book $100,000 in lease revenue, $25,000 in depreciation expense. That is going to flow through their P&L statement, affect their profitability. Now, years two and three of the lease, and you notice this is a lot more straightforward than when you do a finance lease and you got to set up a lease amortization table and how much revenue is recorded. We don't have to do any of that here. We don't have a lease receivable. We don't have any interest revenue. Year two, same deal. We increase the cash account when the lessee pays the lessor, but then we've got a liability, okay? But then at the end of the year, we recognize that revenue, we reduce the unearned revenue, book the revenue, okay, $100,000, and again, we have depreciation, $25,000, because I assume that we're using straight-line depreciation. Okay, now, year three, same deal, okay? Increase cash when you would get paid, have this liability, and then book the revenue. It has become earned at the end of the year, okay? And then we got depreciation of $25,000. Now notice the asset has not been fully depreciated. The lessor would continue to depreciate the asset beyond year three, because remember, the lessor will depreciate the asset over its entire economic life, which in this example was 10 years. So the lease is done, right? The lease is done after year three, but the lessor still has the asset. they still have the asset, and they expect to have a total of 10 years. So there's an additional 7 years where they're going to continue to record depreciation. Now, notice, at the end of year three, with a finance lease, you had to put the asset back on the lessor's statement of financial position. We don't have any journal entry for you. We don't have to do that here because we never took the asset off of the lessor's statement of financial position. So we don't have to put the asset back on when we have an operating lease.